In this video, I'll be discussing an important topic with you all, which you all are very confused in, that is reactive power input to a rectifier. So what I'll be talking about is this term, reactive power. Okay? So first of all, let us understand what is this reactive power and how does it happen, or how does it is or how is it required in case of rectifier. What happens in a rectifier that we talk about reactive power. See, what happens when we have a voltage something like this. Suppose Vm sin omega. And suppose we have a current like this, Im1 sin omega t minus phi 1 plus, suppose it is half wave symmetric, so we will only have odd harmonics, sin 3 omega t minus phi 3 and so on. Now what we know is, when we want to find real power, when we want to find real power, we only consider the terms having same frequency. So these two terms have same frequency in current and voltage, Vm, Im1 by 2 cos phi 1. So this is the real power, or you can say actual power. But then apparent power is given as Vrms multiplied by Irms. From this expression, Vrms is how much? Vm by root 2. And how much is Irms? Half Im1 square plus Im3 square and so on. So that is your apparent power. Now as we can see, this real power and apparent power are not equal. So this reactive power is basically defined in order to understand the difference between the real power and the apparent power. In order to understand what is the difference between two, we define the term reactive power. So what we say that reactive power is Q equal to under root S square minus P square. That is your reactive power. Now to understand this reactive power, first we have to understand what is this apparent power. See, apparent power is nothing but the product of voltage and current. Now if I give you 10 ampere current and 5 volt voltage, what we expect that the power in the system should be 50 watt. 5 into 10, it should be 50 watt just by looking at the voltage and current. Now if we expect it to be 50 watt, that is called as apparent power. The power that should be present, but we can't actually have that power. It seems that the power should be 50, but power is never 50. That power is called as your apparent power. So apparent power is the virtual power that we think is present in the circuit. Why we think that? Because in the system, we have voltage and current, and based on their product, we expect the power to be V into I. That is your apparent power. But actually, power is this much. That is your real power or the actual power. And to understand the difference between them, we define the term reactive power. We also define one term in rectifier, which is called as input power factor, IPF. That is real power by apparent power. Okay. So input power factor is nothing but how much fraction of apparent power is the real power or the useful power. See, when we say that apparent power is 5 into 10, 50, we expect the power to be 50. That is not the power that is present in the circuit, but based on voltage and current, the power should have been 50. But only some part of it is actually present in the circuit. Only some part of it we are able to utilize, and what fraction of it is utilizable is called as the input power factor. Okay, we are only able to utilize P amount of power out of S. S is the expected power that we could have utilized, is called as input power factor. Okay, this you might be knowing very well right now. So now let us move on to the main thing, that is how to derive this reactive power. See, reactive power generally we write like this: Vrms Irms sin phi. This is what you study in the networks. Now let me make you understand a bit about the rectifiers. Whatever rectifiers we study, we assume them to be lossless, right? We assume them to be lossless. If these are lossless, then what I can say? That input power will always be equal to the output power, right? Input power should be same as the output power because it is lossless. If such a thing happens, then we know real power input is real power output, which is most of the times V naught average into I naught. But this is only applicable for highly inductive load. For highly inductive load, current is taken as constant, and then we can say V naught average into I naught, and this can also be V naught RMS square by R for the case of purely resistive load. Okay, so that is your output power, which will be equal to the input power. From here we know the real input power. Now we have two power factors. One is called as input power factor IPF, which is your how much real power upon VRMS IRMS, just now which I explained, that is input power by S. Other power factor is called as displacement power factor. Or DPF, it is cos phi 1. What is this cos phi 1? If you see, this is called as fundamental voltage. Fundamental means having minimum frequency. So minimum frequency is omega, because other frequencies are always higher than omega. This is your fundamental current. Now see the sinusoidal term in them. The phase difference between fundamental voltage and current is phi 1. If they are displaced by phi 1, then displacement power factor is basically cos phi 1. That is cos of angle between fundamental voltage and fundamental current. Now, as you can see in this derivation, real power is only due to fundamental. Why only due to fundamental? Because voltage only had fundamental. So real power is only due to fundamental. Voltage does not have harmonic. That is why real power is only due to the fundamental voltage and fundamental current. So now, while deriving reactive power, we have two options. We have to either calculate fundamental reactive power. Fundamental reactive power means reactive power contributed by fundamental component, that is VRMS, which is Vm by root 2. Voltage does not have harmonic, but current has harmonic. We are talking about fundamental, that is why I am 1 by root 2. I am only taking the fundamental component, sin phi 1. We just now evaluated that real power is Vm by root 2 Im1 by root 2 into cos phi 1, which means this Q1 by P is tan phi 1, or you can say Q1 is P10, phi 1. Now remember this phi 1. Phi 1 is equal to alpha. Alpha is the firing angle for full converter. And phi 1 is equal to alpha by 2 for semi-converter. Semi-converter means half-controlled converter in which thyristors as well as diodes are present. So, fundamental reactive power is P tan alpha for full converter and it is also P tan alpha by 2 for semi-converter. Also, I told you this real power is given by V naught into I naught for highly inductive load. Okay, so this is your fundamental reactive power. If you want total reactive power, total reactive power, how will I calculate? So we know Q by P is tan phi, where cos phi is called as your input power factor. Input power factor, how did I calculate? P by S. Now Q will be equal to P tan phi. So here phi is input power factor angle. Okay. In the previous expression I told Q1, that is fundamental reactive power, is P tan phi 1, where phi 1 is fundamental displacement angle, that is the angle between fundamental voltage and current. Here phi is the overall power factor angle or the input power factor angle. So there are two definitions of reactive power. One is only for fundamental and one is overall. In most of the test series and most of the questions, what you are asked to find is this one. That is your fundamental reactive power. So what we do is we calculate real power through the output values and then we multiply it by tan alpha or tan alpha by 2 to find out the fundamental reactive power. But do remember that there are two types of reactive power, either fundamental reactive power or input reactive power. So mostly fundamental reactive power is asked and there is very less probability that it will be asked in GATE because there will be a controversy or there will be confusion regarding which reactive power is being asked. And that is why this hasn't been asked in GATE. But most of the test series you will find such questions. So remember, fundamental reactive power is calculated using fundamental displacement factor and input reactive power is computed using input power factor. Okay, there are two power factors in rectifier. One is the overall and one is for fundamental. I hope now this confusion is clear regarding the reactive power. Thank you.